quickly, let's read three scriptures. Let's start by reading Ephesians 3 and verse 20. And we want to repeat it together, all of us together. Can you put it in one of the best translations like Message? Oh, watch ayo. Hata ayo ni poa. Amen. Hata ayo ni poa. Now let's say it together. Now unto him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that works in us. Let's say it again. Now to him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above that, according to the power that works. Oh, hallelujah. Please go singing that song. Now unto him. Your life, you're committing it to him. Now your business, you're committing it to him. Your family, you're committing it to him. Who is, he is able. He can do exceedingly, abundantly, above. So you think here, he goes above. You are thinking about 10,000, he goes to 20. You are thinking down here, a bungalow, he's thinking of a machinette for you. You are thinking about a farm of 1/8, he wants to give you an acre. Let's give it to him who is able. Bless the name of the Lord. Let's read another verse in the book of Exodus 3 and verse 8. Because those verses I'm going to use interchangeably. Exodus, it says this. So I have come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptians and to bring them up from that land to a good, and I want to add land there, to a good land and to a large land, to a land flowing with milk and honey, to the place of the Canaanites, the Hittites, the Amorites, the Perizzites, and the Hevizzites, and the Jebusite. Oh, I like that. And the Kikuyite, and the Luoite, and Kalenjiniite, and Evryite and Ite that are around us. You know, God is going to come down, but he is going to come down because we are going to call him. God, come down even for the this Al-Shababuite. Come and Lord, deliver us. That's a kind of prayer. And God is saying, I want to come down, but I cannot come until you call me. We are going to use that verse also very, very shortly. I hope I'll be able to keep myself there. Then let's read 2-3 verses, and then I'll give you that illustration so that I can feel a part of what is happening, and then I'll start sharing. 2 Kings chapter number 4. These verses, when I saw them, I got amused. That God, where Mungu ni wa ajabu? You know, sometimes we look at what Jesus did, and we think it's only Jesus that can do, but God has given us power to do the same things. Actually, he says greater things. Greater things. Listen to this story. One day, a man arrived from Baal Shalisha and brought the man of God bread of the fruit, of the first fruit, 20 loaves of barley bread and newly ripened grain in his kapshak. And he said, give it to the people that they may eat. Now that is a servant of the Lord who is telling this man who has come to him to give it to the people. But you know, I like another translation that I read. One day a man arrived from Baal Shalisha. He brought the man of God 20 loaves of fresh baked bread from the early harvest, along with a few apples, I like that, from the orchard. Then Elisha, the servant of the Lord, said, pass it around to the people to eat. His servant said, oh, for 100 men, there is not nearly enough. So Elisha said, just go ahead and do it. God says there is plenty. Oh man, God, you are wonderful. And sure enough, there was. He passed around what he had. They not only did they eat, but they had leftovers. Tell your neighbor, we serve a God of leftovers. A God of leftovers. Those are the three verses that I'm going to use as I share this morning. But I want to give you a little illustration. Maybe it might not connect with what I'm saying, but it will bring me closer to you. Someone was writing a report to the insurance, and he was writing from hospital bed. He had been had an accident, and he was in the bed. Now he wanted to say what happened to that experience. So he said, this is what he said. Me, I'm a bricklayer. Mimi ni kada ya kujenga na mawe. I lay bricks, najengaga na mawe. So he says, on this particular day, I was up on the sixth floor, and I had finished my work for the day, and there's some bricks that I wanted to bring down. So I went down and tied a pulley so that I can lower them with the pulley. And then went up, filled the pulley, the trolley up to pull it down, to pull them down. I filled it with mnaita nini hiyo mawe, hiyo bricks, mawe ama ya 9 ama ya 6 akawekelea juu. Blocks, thank you, sir. Oh, man, sometimes English. Came by sea. So, then he went down so that he can release, so that that katrole on the pulley can come down. So, he held the rope so that he can be releasing. So, mtu anawachaga hivi, ili iteremke, kwa sababu nikuteremsha, unateremsha. He weighs 130. He was very light, actually lighter than me, because me, I'm not 130. Bless God. So he held so tightly. Na akajifunga vizuri. But I don't know what happened. That pulley, when he released it, he forgot to release the kamba so that the kapuli can come. But he had put more bricks there, heavier than him. So your guess is as good as mine. He refused to release it. So what happened? He went up. When he was up halfway, he met the bricks on the katrole coming down. So what they did, so he says, when I was halfway, we met. So that's why I have a fractured head and I have limbs here broken, and that's what happened. But he got unconscious and he did not release it. So he went up and then he hit the roof. But because he was holding it, the pulley came down and hit the ground. A few bricks, they fell out. So now the trolley is lighter and the guy is heavier. So what happened? Your guess is as good as mine. The guy is coming down so fast. So he meets the trolley again. It hits him a few rips and he breaks a few. And then he goes down, still holding. Then when he was down there, he gained his conscience. He said, ah, God, you're so good. So he released. Now your guess is as good as mine. Now the thing came down and hit his legs, both of them, and broke them. And then he said, now that is what happened. Now I get closer to you because you have also enjoyed what I have said. God, that God that you and I have trusted him, we are saying he is able. He is able to do abundantly. He is able to do not only exceedingly, not only abundantly, but he is able to do above a few things. And they are all conditions upon by what I'm thinking. So I am the one who allows God to do abundantly, exceedingly, because I have aroma till you called I'm thinking. I am thinking. Bless the name of Jesus. God is a God of abundance. And what if you can call it anything. These are the summons that you can call them anything. You can call them more than enough. You can call them the God of abundance. You can call them the God who leads us through the valleys. That's the song that I wanted to sing, When You're Up in the Mountain, by Linda Randall. That's the song I wanted to sing. I would have sung almost like her, but I felt a bit shy because I did not know the key. But key G, I thought I used to know, but they sang with a better key than mine. Hiyo ni kuonyesha kuna rasti kidogo. But you can give it whatever title you want. But it is good to say this. God's blessings are more abundant than we realize. God's blessings are more abundant than we realize. But most of the times we don't realize how much more we really have when God is in the picture. You don't realize what you have if God is in the picture. So a lot of times we are complaining, we are struggling, and so on and so forth, and yet God is in the picture. If God is in the picture, then we should know that he is God of blessing, he is God of more abundance, he is more God who can give me exceedingly and is going to use me as I think. So two things quickly I want to bring here. One, sometimes the blessings of your stewardship is not for you. It is for someone who may be suffering more than you. And that's why I want to use this illustration of Elisha. Elisha could not suffer depression like Elijah was because Elisha had company. He used to work with a company of people. So this particular day, somebody wants to bless him, and he comes with barley loaves, 20. And he comes with a few apples. I like the apples. Me, I like apples. Do you? A few apples. And then he brings to him, but this servant of the Lord says, wait. Give them, serve it to them. And this poor man looks at the servant of the Lord. He says, but these guys are 100. What I have is 20. How? What is going to happen? He tells him, the Lord. And I think one of the things that I need to go and discover is that it all depends on whose hands what I have is being held. You know, somebody says this. For a runner, like someone in Jamaica, you know him. When he's given the button to run, and he is the last to run, when you see them exchange, all of us think I can get it, isn't it? Kupewa tu, naweza pewa. But you know what? Unaweza pewa upigwe lap. Na ni 100 meters, lakini upigwe lap. Yani aende amalize na arudi, we bado una struggle ukiendelea tu kumaliza. So it all depends with who. You know, you give the ball to Ronnie. And the other day he messes up Aston Villa. And Manu, we are coming. Yeah, we are coming. I mean, don't write us off. We are coming. Because even Chelsea lost. Is that not good ideas for the people that love soccer? But Liverpool, we are still winning. Never walk. I like that, their slogan, never walk alone. Sometimes the blessings that God brings are the stewardship, the things that God has blessed us with, they are not ours. Actually, they are for others. So when this man of God was blessed, he said, give it to people. Why? And this guy said, they're not enough. He's told, no. Your business is not to know whether it is enough. And that is the same thing that Jesus tells his disciples. Cause them to sit in groups and give them the bread. Serve it. Give them the fish. And the Bible records that there were leftovers. When they were starting, there were few, but there were leftovers. This is the God that we trust in. He's the God of leftovers. There will always be something left behind. Bless the name of the Lord. So he brought with him the tithe, the first fruit that he had, the tithe, the offering of his stewardship, to offer to the prophet. Now get this. Instead of the prophet using it, the prophet equally, in an act of stewardship, instructed the man to be a blessing to the more needy people that were around him. Give it to them. Release it to them. And this is where the first thought of what is happening comes in. Sometimes the greater blessings of your stewardship is not for you. Rather, it is for others who may be hurting, people that are suffering more than you are. Bless the name of the Lord. So my stewardship, the things that God has given me. And I said we are going to talk about money this time until we receive our 200 million in November by the grace of the Lord. So sometimes God calls on us so that what we have, we can release it to others. We sacrifice a little more. But the point that I want to bring to you is that the man of God says to him, now God is going to do something. God is able. Pass it around to the people to eat. For 100 men, oh, there's not nearly enough. Elisha said, just go ahead and do it. Because God says there is plenty. There is plenty. Where it's coming from is only that you don't know. You cannot see. And I think what God is trying to tell us is to open our eyes. There is a story recorded of Elisha and his servant. Elisha and his servant, there are things that are happening. And the servant of the Lord does not know what to do. The servant of the Lord wakes up and he looks at the hills and he sees they are surrounded. And they were surrounded and it was real trouble. He goes back, he wakes his master. Master, what are we going to do? And the master is still asleep. Because the master has opened up his eyes and he can see different. No wonder he prays a prayer, Lord, open up his eyes. Tell your neighbor, I think what we need is the Lord to open our eyes. Because if you open your eyes, then you know who is with you. You know, when his eyes opened, actually, I think he took a stool and went outside to read the newspaper. Do you know why? Because he saw between them and those guys, there were angels. And then let me tell you what the servant of the Lord, he comes out and he says, who are you looking for? And they say, we are looking for Elijah. Is he around? He says, yes. Now let me take you where he is. They all become blind. He holds them. He takes them to where Elijah is, you know. I mean, it's so fantastic. He takes them to the compound of the king. And then he said, Lord, open their eyes. Now, I don't know whether you are getting the point. The point is, when you open your eyes is when you realize and you can know the power and the grace that the Lord has blessed us with. The power and the grace that God has left us with. The little boy with 5 loaves and 2 fishes, that was a sandwich for the boy, but God gave it to 5,000 men. This is fantastic. God can do it. He's a God of more than enough. The second thing that I find from that passage, and I want to bring it to you, never underestimate God's abundance. Never. Never underestimate God's abundance. As bad as things might get, the church and the people of the church are called upon to witness and to testify that we must never underestimate God's abundance. God's abundance. God's abundance. Remember what he has said. Look at the man in the scripture. He is so skeptical. He does not believe that what he is called upon to offer is sufficient to feed 100 people. All that he has is 20 loaves of barley and a few fresh ears of grain in his sack. That's what we read in the New King James. But in the Message Bible Amplified, this is what they say, 20 loaves of fresh baked bread from the early harvest, along with a few apples from the orchard. It is as if he is embarrassed to offer so little to so many. But Elisha insists that he give it away. In so doing, he learns God abundance in a time of scarcity. Because not only did they eat, but there was supply. Yes, we are living in a time when we might say that the economy is weak, is frail. We are living in a time when we are saying few of us have no job opportunities. We are living in a time when actually we are scared from every corner in terms of security and other things. But we are also living in a time when they that know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploit. They shall be strong and they shall do exploit. Because it is in those times that I feel weak when God proves himself strong. I open my eyes and I see God and I sleep. A few years ago, and I have given this testimony when I had 3 guys in the university. That's my wife, my daughter, and my son. And I don't know. May God help. You know, wa mama, wa dada, mbarikiwe sana. Lakini wakati mwingine, saidiani wazee. Saidia wazee kidogo. Sa kidogo tu, saidia wazee. So we would sit around and the schools are opening the following week. And as usual, I would ask them, Alice, how much money do you need? She would tell me. Nyambura, how much money do you need? She'll tell me. Mungai, how much money do you need? They'll tell me. And then I'll tell them, how much is the total? They'll tell me the total. And then I'll tell them, let us pray. And I go to bed and sleep. And I would actually sleep very, very well, like someone who has just come from the gym. Fresh. Under the sauna or jacuzzi. Yani, you feel fresh. And I will sleep very well. Now the question is, how do you sleep? Because you know, one thing I know, I might not have it, but God has it. And when I sleep, I wake up fresh. Then I have ideas on who to talk to. Because you don't talk to everybody. God has to lead you to people that you talk to. And you know, the slogan was easy. Unamkopa chitala. Amen. Chitala wakati yake imefika, alipwe. Unaenda kwa Rafael. Unakopa Rafael, ulipe chitala. Shule inafungwa. Amen. Shule inafanya nini? Nafungwa. Si wamemaliza? Yeah. So, unakopa church cooperative, halafu una, Yani survival tu. Na jamaa wakamaliza. I remember one day, and I hope my son will receive it easy. One day, I wanted my son to learn something. So I borrowed money from church. And somebody was to withdraw it in town. And we were with my son in town having a cup of tea. See, only poor. So money was brought, 100K I was given. Then I gave it to him. Said, weka kwa mfuko, twende. Tukaanza safari ya Eldoret. Kaona, hey, sasa ni saa saba. Tukifika Eldoret bank, zikauza mifungo. Nikamwambia, sasa ingia pale ulipe. Lipa kitu kidogo. Lipa kitu kama gapi. Si ulipe kama 70. Do you know by the time we got to Eldoret, for the first time my son told me, Dad, I salute you. Because he discovered life can be easy sometimes. Some of us have impressed our children, but we know it is only by the grace of God. Kweli kabisa, yani ni neema tu. Neema. Neema. Zikaisha ep. Zote ep. Na nilikuwa nikienda Kericho kuhubiri. So nilipo muacha, mimi nikaendelea na safari. Lakini akaona pesa tumeingia Nakumat. Tukajitetea kidogo na vitu alizyotaka. Na hiyo ikawa tuko na deni ya shule. Na deni zingine. Na si alimaliza. Si alimaliza. Sasa shida ni wale walifikiria nilikuwa na pesa. Watoto wangu walipomaliza na mke wangu amemaliza degree ya kwanza anaenda ya pili, wanafikiria naweza wakopesha. Bishop, si unaweza nipa 100K. But you know, how I feel when you ask 100K to me, I feel great. Now, the answer I give you is the one that even greater. Hey, you have come. Thank you for thinking about me. But right now, oh man, right now, right now, right now. And then you go home smiling that you say, ni right now. I'm a kosa right now. Because why should I tell you sitapata? Nitapata. Lakini right now, my brother, right now, things are not well. Never underestimate God. Never. Never underestimate God. Not at any cost. Never. Because unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that works in us, if you know him, if you have faith in him, then your life actually will be different. How do I say this? Because I want to ask this question and I finish. And the question is, I'm asking is, where are you? Where are you? Where are you? Exodus 3:8 we read. It is God who is saying, is it me? Or is it you? Please, please. Hiyo Wi-Fi, siuvute ini, wacha kuni, yeah, watia kukushia, wacha ni ubiri vizuri. Now it is God who is speaking. And I pray that God will speak to you, because when he speaks to you, he will put some faith in you. He will put some confidence in you. This is God speaking. But the story is this. These guys were there 400 years. They were in slavery. 400 years. And life was not that good. But because they prayed, God heard and came down. And my prayer is, in this year of great exploit, we will call on God. And God will come down na hata tuma mtu. You know, because akituma mtu atakuringia. Najua, nimeomba, nikasikia, nikama, George, unahitaji 200 shillings. Alafu nikukupatia na uwe ukikumbuka, eh? Ukumbuke, yeah, yeah. You know, God wants to do it so that you will not honor anybody. But God will come down and say, I have heard. And I have come. May God come. Because he has a heart. But then, have you called him? Have you called him? So that he can come. And I want to give you three places you can be. But I pray that we can move together and get to the last place. Which is the place that I pray that God will take me one of these days. Hallelujah. Oh God, you are so good. Hata sahi watu wananiuzia mashamba. Na manyumba. Oh my goodness. Now I don't tell them I will not buy. I'll tell them. Sahizi, I have some deep commitment. You know why? Because one of these days they will come and I will have money and I will buy it. Yeah? But right now, commitment. So, nimeona nyingi ekatano pale Ridgeways. Na unazunguka zote ekatano. How much per acre? 55. Eh? 55 only? Okay. So, in total, you don't bargain. Because you are not buying. And you leave them suspecting that you are a good buyer. So, you know. You don't park your car like you are running, you know. You park your car like you're not moving anywhere. Yani unaingiza ndani. Oh, I like that. When I was taught that principle, now I drive well. Sio kukaa kama unaogopa, unaingiza vizuri. There is actually one house. Nilikuwa nikiuziwa hapa Runda. Niliitwa tu kuja. Bishop, kuna nyumba mzuri sana. Iko wapi Runda? Ha, sawa. Tukutana wapi? Hata sitakuja. Ndio hii. Nikaenda. Na nikaingia ndani nikapark. Kauliza mwenyewe yuko. Mwenyewe akatoka. Kamuliza, wewe unaweza kubali nyumba iuzwe ukiwa ndani? Because it was being auctioned by a bank. Unaweza kubali, si ukatae. Si ujitetee. Alafu ule nikampigia hapana hiyo kama hiyo sinunuagi. Iko na mama ndani na mtoto. Sinunu. Nikaambiriwa ingine. Huko. Sasa hiyo nikachunga si kuingia ndani. Nisije nikakuta mama na mto. Kwa sababu nyumba kama imejengwa na iko na gate, wanaiuza, ni benki ilikuwa ikiuza. Alafu wananipiga, wananiambia, unajua wewe bishop, ile lazima itauzwa, nunua tu. Hapana, sinunuai kama hizo. Jenga ingine ikiwa mpya uniite. Kama haijaigiwa na mtu na kuja kukaa ndani yake. Sawa. So that is the kind of life. Because I told you, now we have to start living in a different style. Yeah, you have to start living in a different style. Although I told you to go to Serena, don't go every day. Don't go every month. But occasionally, treat yourself. You know, maybe I said I went to Serena for somebody who had, you know, it is, you are, when you are cutting a big deal, you can go anywhere. But don't go there every, you are allowance yako itaisha. Na alafu unasema, Bishop alisema tuwe tukija, pana utashikwa, utaenda kunaitwa kucho. Kuchonga viazi. Utaenda pale kule kazi yako the whole day. Utachonga viazi na mchele. So it is not every day. Amen. It's not every day we go to Java. But occasionally we go to Java. And we are so busy with our laptops and we are, you know, and so on. And then we are only asking for a cup of tea. For a big deal that we are doing. Occasionally we can have chips and steak. But we don't go to Java for meals. Always. But we don't. Hata Raira anaendaga kwa yule mama. Mnajua yule mama mwingine pale. Kwa hivyo sio kila siku anaendaga Intercontinental. Kuna wakati anaendaga kwa huyo mama pale. Ni Moi Avenue. Eh, na anapelekaga wadosi huko. Hata Kalonzo wamepelekwa kule. Jonjo wamepelekwa kule. Kwa sababu it's not always. They teach me a lot. Because sometimes I fear these people. You think they go to eat every lunch hour. They don't. But occasionally treat yourself. Walk like you can afford. And I also told you, if somebody insists, take him there. Wewe uwe ni wakati wako wa maombi uitishe maji moto, unywe polepole. Kwa sababu unaombea inchi. Oi! Wani lazima uambie kila mtu hauna pesa. Hapana leo. Na nimeenda na watu wengi na nimejua hiyo, wameniidhira. Ya nataka nikule ya kule na kunywa maji moto na ndimu. Na akisikia inalipishwa, kuna hoteli tugine tunalipishaga hiyo maji moto na dimu, naongeza asali. Unasema, basi nipatie maji ya mfereji, lakini iwe moto. Bless the name of the Lord. Those are. So where are you? Have you called on God? Has he come? And I want to give you three places that you can be, and then I'll finish. One of the places we will start with the children of Israel is when they were in captivity. In captivity. And the first thing that I want to bring to you is that you can have barely enough. Barely enough. The children of Israel had barely enough. In actual fact, survival was hard. Even the straws, they had to look for it. They would work hard. But even having a meal was a challenge. They were slaves in Egypt. Barely enough. And some of us can find ourselves in those situations where we, it's like we are slaves or something. We work so hard, we toil so hard, but we cannot even have bread on the table. It's barely enough. It's like surviving. It's like although they were talking about cucumbers, they were suffering, they were enjoying the cucumbers by looking at them or working on the shambas. But then we can be in a place where barely enough, We are doing it for others. We make them wealthy. We make them rich. They have everything. But for you and your family, you are having bare enough. It's barely enough. And I tell you this, with all honesty, most of us start there. Most of us will go through there where it is barely enough. You work so hard. You toil so hard. But you cannot have a quarter in your dairy. Ni sukuma wiki moja na inatembea huko kwa githeri. Inatembea huko. Yani inaswimu huko dani. Yani kwa sababu di uli afford. But you know what? Barely enough is not a place that you mekorogewa. It is just a season in life. Are you calling on God? In that situation of where you are bare enough, you need to call on God. And you need to hear him say, I have come. Because I have heard you, I have come. And my prayer is that a lot of us who are in that level now, we will call on God because this is the year of exploit, and we will move from bare enough. We will move towards having enough and surplus in the name of Jesus. Bless the name of the Lord. Why was it barely enough? It's because you are given. Let me recite this thing that I had my father. My father was a very humorous preacher. Oh my goodness. What a humor. Sometimes I think I copied him, you know. Very humorous. He one day he preached a sermon that I thought he was trying to tell preachers, waacha kutaka mali sana, you know, because he was coming from Kiawamadena, you know, where you have to suffer a lot so that God can hear you a lot. But anyway, he used to tell me that all the works that the people used to work for the Wazungus, you would never prosper. Actual fact, he used to tell me, I work for the Mzungu, then my family will also work for the Mzungu, and their children work for the Mzungu, because Mzungu has given you a 10 by 10, a place where you sit, and some of your children sleep under, and others above. And others, and the Mzungu can allow you to put another one, ya matope hapo inje, ya familia yako. But all of you will work there. That's what Mzungu had designed it. And how he had designed it was this. And they used to sing. And poor mothers, our mothers. Oh, our mothers had a wonderful song. And they used to enjoy it. And I pray that you will not enjoy in a place of bare enough. Wana motho goe wira no die ole gale gae wira no da wana motho goe no ole gale gae wira no. Did you hear what I say? And when you see a Mzungu, run, because work is food. They gave you food on Friday, enough for 1 week. They gave you Porsche for 1 week, and when it is over, it's over. Barely enough. No wonder some of us could not go to school. Why? Because our parents, they enjoyed kuregarega. And I want to say in the name of the Lord, I will not regarega here. I will not regarega in the name of Jesus. Because I don't want to be in the bare enough. I'm going to move where I'm going. In actual fact, I'm talking to someone. If where you are is only food, then what is happening in your housing? You need to move out and look for a place where you can have food and housing. And if it's only food and housing to some of you, move. Keep on moving. You need not only food and housing, you need some saving. And if you have moved to a place where you have food and save and a little saving, but you cannot purchase a plot, move. Keep on moving. Bare enough. Tell your neighbor, hapo ni pali pabaya sana. Na umuangalie tena umabie kata. Amekataa kweli. Unajua nilikuambia ukae na mtu wako na imani, anaona umekataa kweli. Ama ni ile tu umerudia vile bishop amesema. Do you know in church some of you don't get it because you only repeat. Can you allow your spirit to feel it? Kuregarega so that you can begin a portion. And it is only for that week. Then the other week there was no surplus. Bare enough. The second place, and we are picking the children of Israel. They had called on God and God had come. The second point, just enough. It is there, but it cannot be saved. That is in the wilderness. You know, although in the wilderness, the statement that is so good is after 40 years. You know what they were told? It was recorded like this. The reporter, the nation reporter of those days said this. They were so blessed that the clothes that they left Egypt with, aikutapasuka, atakiatu aigetoraka. In other words, ebu wacha nikuachie hapo, nimeona kama umehang, nikurudie kidogo. The manna that came for them in the wilderness was just enough. If you decided you are wiser than anybody else and you kept more, what happens? They would have something terrible. They would stink. Just enough. When they complain, we want meat, we want meat, we want meat, we want meat. In actual fact, I read the story how the quails got there. and I thought, God, you are so wonderful. Because God caused a wind to blow the quails. Na wanakuja wengi. Yani hata ukifanya hivi unachika, ukifanya hivi unachika, ukifanya hivi unachika. Lakini mukisha shika, hizo zingine zinapewa nguvu na Bwana, zinahepa. Baka kesho yake mletewe ndege wengine. He has to blow again. God blow the quails. I mean, don't you open your eyes and tell God to blow for the quails? Kwa sababu hata quails ni vizuri. Yani usikule tu mana. Iwekwe kasupu kakakweru kidogo. Kakakweru kidogo. But the question I'm asking myself, although the mana is good, and although my clothes can stay for longer, faith, just stand up. Faith, let me ask you, how would you like to wear that dress for 40 years? You wouldn't. Oh my goodness, she says she wouldn't. I wouldn't either. 40 years. Well, now imagine 40 years. Sasa, think about me, 40 years. You know, 40 years, I was this, then this, then this, then this, and now I'm heading this way back again. Hiyo guo ingekuwa imepasuka ama ingekuwa bado iko. Na nikusema tu 40 years, ingekuwa kwa ama ingekuwa imepasuka. Peter, ingekuwa kwa kweli, kwa imeisha. Hiyo ingekuwa imeisha. Kwa sababu ukienda hivi, harafu unaenda hivi. Esther anapunguza, Esther, baka hiyo kamulaini kaliwe kwa mbeleni kanaanza kukura. Inakatika hapo kwa sababu hili imedunga dungu sana. Are you understanding? So even justice not enough is not good enough. Because although there is provision, we need to move to where God is taking us, a place of surplus. This year that we are doing, we have great exploit, should be a year that we, where we are, amen. And maybe I'm talking to some of us. Sasa Bwana akubariki. Bwana akubariki. Hata kama utaenda kwa Gikomba, utafute kamera. Angalau, afadhali Bwana. Afadhali Bwana. You know, there was a time when I was younger without feeling embarrassed at all. Because it is good not to feel embarrassed. I would leave Thika with no change. Kuna nguo ya kubadilisha? Ninaanza kwenda kuhubiri. Na ninatoka Thika, naenda Naikuru, naenda Joro, naenda Moro, naenda Kericho, naenda Kisi, naenda Githumo. Narudia Eldoret. Wacha kuniangalia hivyo na kunihurumia. Lakini vizuri nikwambie, mahali pengine kama Kericho, utoi nguo. Baridi ni nyingi. Lakini Kisumo, Bwana asifiwe, unaosha zote. Kwa sababu Bwana nao kule ameleta neema. Usiku zinakauka asubuhi. Huyo ni Mungu wa maajabu. Lakini hiyo maisha sitaki tena. Ni nzuri, provision ya Mungu, kweli kabisa. Na hata kiatu akikuwa kikipakwa rangi, unapanguza tu na majani na unaendelea tu. Hallelujah. Kwanza kilikuwa kiatu kizuri, si cha bata. Ni kiatu kile mtu anaendaka kwa sokoni, anapatia mtu mguu, kwa ukoguru. Anachora. Na kwa hiyo ni kiatu ambayo hata ukipiga mawe, inavunja. Kiatu poa sana. Tena ilikuwa platform. Siniliwambia niliishi hiyo miaka ya platform. Na suruali ni berobo, bottom. Na hapa hakuna mfuko, kwa hivyo hata sina haja ya pesa. Nikamfuko kamoja tuka hapa nyuma, tuka kuweka kakitamba. Huyo ni Mungu wa maajabu. Lakini nyakati zile, zilikuwa nzuri. Bwana Yesu apewe sifa. It was just enough. I was not naked. And I looked. Sasa mumeninyonga kwa nini? Oh, ni stima. Nilifikiria ni nyinyi, mliambiwa mzime kitu. Nikafikiria sasa mmejaza. Kwa hivyo ni stima, eh? Just enough. May God help us to move from just enough. Hallelujah. And I'm praying this year a lot of us are moving there to a place of more than enough. That is the place that I want to finish with. And I'm asking, where are you? In the place of more than enough is the scripture that we read. That the servant of the Lord has, he knows who he has believed. And he's telling the man who has brought some loaves, give the 100 people. Give them the apples. Let them enjoy it. And then the guy is saying, it's not enough. He's told, no, God. You get to a place where you can say God. Tell your neighbor God. A place where you can say God. Yani, Mungu. My God will supply my needs according to his riches in glory. My God. A place where you discover it is not, it's not you. But let me tell you, that place where God wants to take you is not cheap, is not easy. You have to dress up well, put on the whole armor of God, because the Canaanites live there, the Perizzites live there, the Amorites live there, the Ites that you run away from live there. So you have to arm yourself and go with your God. And the second thing that has to happen, anybody who has no faith in that God, for Kenyatta, the senior, to be the prime minister of this country, the governor who was sent here by King George had to do what? Siunisaidi had to? For Moi to be the president of this country. That's not good. Because the guy had to die. But you know, some have to die and others have to live. For Kibaki, Moi had to? Thank you for retire. That's a better word than to retire. For Kibaki, for Uhuru to come into power, Kibaki had to. And that principle, and I said it here some other day, that principle is the same. For you to succeed, there are some things that will have either to go or they will have to die. Some of them could be habits. Some of them have to die. Some of them could be the things that you hold to. So dear, you're hanging there. Some of those things have to die or they have to go. I don't know where you are. And I want to finish. I've actually gone beyond. But I want to finish. Bear enough. Just enough. More than enough. I don't know where you are. I don't know where you are calling God. Because even where we are saying more than enough, the land that flows with milk and honey, you could be seeing the milk and honey there, but a giant is over there. And we said, when you see a giant, you say, giant, Nakija. So some of you are afraid. You need to tell God, give me courage. Actually, I have seen it. My milk is flowing, but it is over there. But what I'm seeing are giants. Lord, give me the strength to tell my giant. Financial giant, show up. Marital giant, show up. Because I can see when I defeat this, I'll get into the land that flows with milk and honey. Are you hearing what I'm saying? That some of us, yes, we are just enough, and we are moving to where there is more than enough, but you can see. Hallelujah. So whatever need it is, barely enough, just enough, or you are more than enough and you're being challenged and you are telling God, give me the power, the grace. You can stand and I'll pray for you. I don't know where you are. That was the question. And now this is where that song that I was trying to sing can come. God of the mountain. Life is easy when you are up on the mountain. And you have got peace of mind like you have never known. But things change when you're down in the valley. Don't lose faith, for you're never alone. For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. When things go wrong, he will make them right. And the God of the good times is still God in the bad times. Hallelujah. Are you still waiting for me to sing? Are you sure I'm going to sing? Don't you have faith that I will not sing? Sauti imekosekana. Let me try and bamboo here. Life. When you're up on the mountain, God peace of mind. Thank you, Anne. You want to sing? Please, let Anne sing it on my behalf. Ni vizuri kuwa na watu ambao wanaweza kukuokoa. Father, as we stand, you know each one of us. The first thing we are saying, God, come. Come, dear Father, like the children of Israel called upon you, and you came down. Father, come down from heaven and meet us at the point of our need in the name of the Lord. Because barely enough is a place of scarcity. And just enough, dear Father, we have nothing we can save. But more than enough is a place we want to go. There could be giants there, yes. But Father, we pray that you're going to arise and your enemies will be scattered. Fight the battles for us. Fight the battles for us in the name of Jesus. We want to move to have more than enough that we can supply to our neighbors. We can bless our neighbors. Our church can be blessed so that we can bless other churches in the name of Jesus. Because God, your God, and besides there is none other. We that are on the mountain, we are reminded that we can go to the valley. And God of the mountain is still God in the valley. So we will not change. We are not chameleons. We will trust God even in the valley. Father, you are telling us, oh God, that we can get to a place where it flows with milk and honey. But Father, we are going to fight the Canaanites. We are going to fight the Jebusites. We are going to fight the Amorites. There are ites that we are going to fight. Father, give us the grace to fight them. In the name of Jesus, give us the power to overcome them. Because we are not going to be where we are today. We are moving. This is the year of movement. And there is movement in the house. There is commotion in the house. Because we are moving. We are packing off to go to the next level. In the name of Jesus. We have sat here for too long. We are moving to the next level. And Father, if the devil arises, whatever giants he brings, we are going to kill him in the faith. In the name of Jesus. Whatever, dear Father, that stands before us, it has to move for us to get into our destiny. In the name of Jesus. You are the Lord of the valley. You are the God of the hill. And Father, we also know that the blood of Jesus Christ can cleanse all the violent sinners and cause them clean in the name of the Lord. Cleanse us from all our failures and faults and cause us to be what you want us to be in the name of Jesus. To God be the glory in Jesus' name. Let's give the Lord praise in the house, shall we?